All right, this is Smoking Joe Gamer coming back. If you tuned in last night, I almost beat Mega Man 4, but I just had to go to bed. I was tired. So anyways, the goal right now is to finish 4 and start playing 5. So after I beat this, I'm probably going to end the stream and then restart it, you know. So let's just get right into it. And you can see I got myself a nice image, so you can see I'm playing the Mega Man Legacy Collection on Xbox One. Alright, here we go. Ah! Which one are you supposed to go through? Hang on. Alright, that's the right one. Oh man, look at these. If I touch any of those, I instantly die. Wow. Yeah, this game's fucking hard. I'm not even sure how to get that. How the hell do I get that? Nope, he can't shoot this while jumping. Alright, never mind, I guess I can't get that then. Yeah, so the wire, he can't shoot it while he's jumping. You have to press up and shoot, and you can grab onto it stuff, but I don't know where that would even be useful in this game, to be honest with you. Should have just done that over there. Oh well. Does it matter which way I go? You see, the other one's a trap. Huh. Wrong button. Okay. That's where you use it. Sure. So there are a couple spots where it's useful. Oh, he, I didn't know he was going to be able to go over that space there. Okay. I didn't... Just like you gotta switch weapons to apply that drop to whatever you actually want, and sometimes the opportunity doesn't really present itself. Alright. Here we go. Alright, I'm just checking the stream to make sure it's working. Alright. Good. Let's go. The hell is this? Oh boy. You gotta shoot him in the forehead. Okay. It can be a little hard to hit it. That's a guaranteed hit. The rain attack. Man, dude, they really kick you back. It's horrible. I never understood that. Like, the other games do it too. Like, you get to these bosses in these levels and you don't even get to respawn here. It doesn't make any sense. Oh, well. Let's try to figure out what he's weak to, I guess. Too bad I didn't get that energy tank, huh? Okay. Ow. There's no way I'm gonna be able to beat him with, like, no health, so the game just really screwed me here. Like, so they expect you to either kill the boss without having full health, or get to the boss without getting hit, which is impossible. I'm gonna just do this again. Well, you know what? Hang on. If I go that way, then I can farm for power-ups, I think. So it looks like they're just gonna keep coming out of there. Oh, never mind. Yeah, let's go back. Hey, nice. Alright. I Oh. Of course, now the game doesn't give me any health. This is ridiculous. You never get good drops when you need them, you know? Or you just never get the right one, either. It's like, okay, I lost some health because I screwed up, and now I need to get health back, and they're just not giving it to me. And extra lives don't do me any good because it's going to kick me all the way back to here when I lose. I want to save right before the boss with full health, and then maybe I have a chance of beating it. Oops. Alright, he's immune to that. He's immune to that, or I missed. He's weak to ring. Okay. So it seems like a lot of these late game bosses are all weak to either dust or ring. It's really tough to hit this guy. Kind of hard to hit them and avoid getting hit. And they send you all the way back here, which is just stupid. Alright. Weak to ring, got it. Alright. That wasn't so bad. we go. Alright. Dang it. Okay, here it is. Every Mega Man game has it. There's always a boss gauntlet near the end. Always. That's what I'm talking about with this game. It's like, even if you figure out what the weakness is, it doesn't do anything. They want you to use the charge shot. That's it. Nothing else hurts them. He's not weak to that. He's not weak to that. He's not weak to that. He's weak to that. Okay. That's his weakness. Okay. He's the only boss that will actually get frozen when you use that. So. Alright. There you go. Oh, and he's weak to Pharaoh. Supposedly. He's weak to it, but he kills you in 3 hits. It's like, what is with this boss? Why did they make him so much stronger than all of the other ones? It baffles me. And it's so hard to dodge his attacks, and then he just walks right into you, and there's nothing you can do about it. Thank you. Alright, that's his weakness. Alright, got him. Yeah, at least at this point in the game, you have all the weapons and you can figure out what the weaknesses are. And sometimes the weaknesses are helpful, but sometimes they're not. There we go. He's weak to draw. Got it. Alright, cool. Yeah, I know what his is now. His is Skull. It's still tough to hit him with it, though. I'm just gonna have to use this now because otherwise I'm never gonna get through this damn game. Alright, but why does it do that? Why does it switch you back to the Buster when you use the energy tank? Hate that. Alright. Skull Man. Alright, not that. Well, I know it's not Feral. Alright, that seems to be hurting him. Yeah. That seems to be doing more than the rest. That's doing like 2 damage instead of 1. Oh, there you go. There's his weakness. But I don't have enough health to beat him, apparently. Alright, he's weak to dust. I don't know who's weak to this, but I'm just gonna keep trying it. No, it's not that. No, he is Bright Man, so he's not gonna be weak to that. What about Toad? He's weak to Toad. I can't avoid getting hit here. It's stupid. So I don't have enough ammo to kill him with this. But I jump into it because I think he's going to shoot the middle one. Alright, but then I'm still stuck in place when he does that. Dude fucking cheats, man. What a cheater. Yeah, but you're guaranteed to get hit in this fight, so. And you're literally stuck in place until you get hit, almost. You know? Alright. So I get to find someone who's weak to this. Let's take a look. Alright. Oh, alright. I mean, it was just process of elimination, really. Like, he had to be weak to something. I'm not gonna beat him. Alright, sure. And then they send you into this fight with no ammo, right? Right. And weak to ring, like usual. Either that or this just does more damage than the others, I don't know. So it sends you back here with full health, but no ammo. Okay. Okay, he appears to be weak to ring, or ring just does more damage, because a lot of things seem to be weak to ring and dust, or maybe those weapons just do more damage. And then once you activate it, you can't switch weapons. Okay. How do you avoid getting hit by those? Alright. This is ridiculous. How the fuck do they expect you to beat this? If you sit right here, then he can't hit you. Alright. I'm just gonna save right here. It's fine. It's Seems like you have to do a fully charged shot to be able to hit him. Huh. Yeah, everything else just bounces off him. That does nothing. Yeah, no, it seems to me like they want you to do a fully charged power shot. Or buster shot, whatever. Alright. So there's no strategy here, just try to avoid getting hit, which is impossible. And then you have to jump with a fully charged shot to be able to hit him, and even then sometimes it misses. See? You gotta be at the top of your... Yeah, you gotta be at the height of your jump to be able to get him. And you just can't avoid getting hit by these fireballs. Like, what do you do here? This is broken. Of course, I don't have any energy tanks. I had to use it against that other broken boss. Who had way too much fucking... Oh. Not helpful. That's it. The only thing you can hit him with is this. And you're guaranteed to get hit by him every time you try to do it. So you gotta slide. So you get all these weapons throughout the game, and in the end, the final boss can be defeated with just the two gameplay mechanics that they just added. They added the slide in 3, they added the charge shot in 4, and by golly, you're gonna use them both. So this is one of those really dumb boss fights where it's like, I could have beat him at the start of the game if you let me challenge him. I always think that's kind of dumb. When the final boss's weakness is something you started the game with, I just think that's dumb. It's like how in Dark Souls, if you want to beat Gwyn, Lord of Cinder, your best option is to just parry everything he does. I fucking hate this game. It doesn't end. And they still don't give you back any of your ammo. This game sucks. This is the worst one yet. Each new Mega Man game just has new levels of bullshittery. To make you wish you were never born. I'll be here for a while. It's like they just make each one longer just for the sake of making it longer. You know? Because the first game only had the 6 robots and then a couple of Dr. Wily stages. 2 had 8 robots. And then 3 had 8 robots, but then they added a whole bunch of. There were a bunch of stages towards the end, and now this is just like, man, they just keep faking you out. So in my opinion, 3 and 4 are just too hard, and this one's just too long on top of it. This one doesn't have very memorable bosses or weapons. A lot of the weapons aren't that useful. So with the introduction of the charged shot, it's like it makes it so that you can kind of do the bosses in any order, because you can just keep hitting them with this. So even when you exploit their weakness, it doesn't always hurt them that much. So I can see how people might like the fact that you can kind of do the bosses in any order and just keep spamming this charge shot. But to me, the real fun and challenge of Mega Man games is, you know, trying to figure out what the boss's weaknesses are and trying to find the best order to fight them in. And I would say the irony of Mega Man games is that they really should be linear to make sure that you have the weapon you need and to make sure, you know, you have the other bonus items, you know, to get through the levels. That's what I think. See, there are plenty of other games that could have been non-linear because you only have one attack, and you know what I mean? So in a game where each boss has a weakness, you really think it should be linear to make sure you can exploit that weakness, and then they can just adjust the difficulty accordingly. Like, for instance, in a game like DuckTales, actually that's a bad example. So DuckTales is non-linear, and it's okay because you only have one attack and every boss is susceptible to it, right? So you could beat those levels in any order, it doesn't matter. So if there's an ideal order to fight all the bosses in, then they should just make you fight them in that order, is what I think. But they made this attack so much more powerful than everything else that it makes sense just to spam it, and you could just kill every boss using just this, and I think that's stupid. Alright, well, I can't sit here all day. All night, rather. Never mind, now I have to keep shooting until I get more health. Sometimes that one spawns in and sometimes it doesn't. Alright. Now what? You've got to be kidding me. I guess I have to use this. No? No. This doesn't make any sense. This is unbeatable. I don't know what he's susceptible to. Maybe I'm supposed to lose. Supposed to shoot that to light up the room. Got it. Alright. Alright, but I can't hit him up there. It doesn't make any sense. I have to use the... No, that doesn't make any sense. Because now I'm out of ammo. This fight doesn't make any sense. When are you supposed to hit him? If I have to look it up on the internet, then that means it's poorly designed, and it's not intuitive. Who designed this stupid game? You need full Pharaoh shot power. What? You need to hit him with a fully charged Pharaoh shot? I didn't know you could charge the Pharaoh shot. Can you charge all of them and the game doesn't bother to fucking tell you that? I didn't know that was even a thing, okay? I didn't even know I could do that, because when does the game tell you? It doesn't. But then sometimes he is in a spot where you can't hit him, so... Alright. So, can you charge all of them? And I just didn't know. Can't charge that one. So somehow you're supposed to know that this is the only one that can be charged. Okay. I mean, maybe on the NES then the instruction manual would have explained it. And maybe that explains why I was barely doing any damage to that boss who was supposed to be weak to it. Maybe I was supposed to charge it all the way. Alright. So that's the only thing, is when you try to play like newer versions of these games, or you play the ROMs or whatever, that you don't have the instruction manual that might have actually explained some of this obscure stuff. And I don't know about you, but when I was a kid, I used to just throw away the box and the manual and the dust sleeve, and, you know, like a lot of kids, I just had a whole stack of cartridges. It just always floors me when they give you the good health power-up when you're at full health. Yeah, so Buster and Pharaoh Shot are the only ones that can be charged. Got it. And the final boss is only weak to a fully charged Pharaoh Shot. Whereas the previous fight, you had to use this charge shot. Like, basically, that's Capcom in a nutshell. It's, we added this new feature, and goddammit, you're gonna use it whether you want to or not. In 3, it was, you're gonna slide, slide, slide. And this one, it's, you are going to fully charge that shot. And there's no chance of getting another energy tank at this point either. So I really think that Mega Man X is just, like, infinitely better than the first 7 Mega Man games. Because in that game you can revisit levels, and there are upgrades to get more maximum health and stuff. So yeah, I think 8 and X are probably like the 2 best games in the series. So imagine trying to do this before the internet, you know? I wouldn't have been able to figure this out if I didn't look it up. It's interesting how when you use the skull weapon, you can, you know, light up the whole room for a second. Yeah, but you only have like 2 seconds to hit him. Yep. Ridiculous. Even when you know where he is, and you can actually have a chance of hitting him. Good luck. Alright, got him. Now what? Alright, I beat Mega Man 4. Now you know it's the end because the achievement popped. So it took me 4 fucking hours to beat that game. Jesus. That's with saving, so if I had to actually, you know, write down passwords and not do that, then, alright. Alright, there we go, so I beat 4. I'm gonna take a quick break, and then I'll come back and start 5.